Hey guys, it's me, Stormy, and here is your weekly horoscope for the week of April 16th. This is the last week, actually April 20th is the last day to take advantage of the spring cleaning goodies that are out and available to you. So make sure you click in the description box down below. And if you stop by stormygrace.com, you will see that my new homepage is under construction. I got a whole story to tell you guys about that, but I'll fill you in on the live chat. So make sure you have your notification button push down. You are subscribed to this channel so you know not only when I upload, but you can also get the notifications for the live streams that are coming up, okay? All right, so this week, this is kind of an interesting week because what we've got going on is we've got two of our long-term planets, our big daddy planets, Saturn and Pluto, taking a retrograde. Venus is going to be in opposition. There's conjunction happening this weekend, this week. The Sun is also changing signs this week. So let's just start at the beginning of the week because I think there's a fair amount to talk about. Now, right here on Tuesday, April 17th, Venus and Jupiter are actually going to be in an opposition. Now, these are our two benefic planets, which means they bring benefit. So even when they're in hard aspect or hard angle to each other, they're still pretty friendly energies, but sometimes too friendly is too much. You know what I'm saying? Now, this being Venus and Jupiter, this can really inflate things. It can make things too big, right? Your wants versus your needs could definitely be at odds with this opposition. So I would tell you, this is not the best energy, especially anything having to do with finance. I would just be very mindful this week with finance if you can avoid borrowing money. I mean, even if it, unless you're like, hey, can I borrow $2 from you? I'll give it back to you right when we're in the car. I mean, if you can't have an immediate return with that, be very mindful of borrowing, because what it seems like is that I only need this amount of money, or I only need to do this, and it's much more inflated. Your thinking is even more inflated about why you actually need the funds at this time. So just kind of keep that in mind. My investors out there, I know now that there are several, this is just not the best time to make that new investment either. Now, what do you do with this energy? What do I think is very good with this? I think it is a great time to review what is a want, what is a need, and practice the gift of pause. Be on pause until you are absolutely certain of the action that you're about to take. Now, the first planet that's going to go retrograde on that same day is Saturn. Saturn's our big daddy. Then right behind that on Sunday, the 22nd, we have got Pluto going retrograde. Now, what's important about the Saturn-Pluto retrograde is that because they're such big planets for us, what they're doing is helping us restructure, helping us bring transformation, right? So they've been alive and awake and well and going in forward motion for some time now. But what Saturn's been doing is showing us in the cracks in our foundation. Where does this not make sense? Where does this structure not work? Where do you need to grow up, right? Any of those kinds of things. And Pluto's right behind it because it's an outer planet. So it's not so close in the personal feeling. It's actually very subtle and sometimes very hard to identify when we're dealing with Pluto energy, but what it's showing you is where you've got to change to level up. Now, they're going to go to sleep for 5 months until September, and while they're asleep, you've gotten your work assignment. You've seen what's not working in your world. You've seen what you need to be working on. The next 5 months are yours to take action to make mature improvement on that, because I promise you, when they wake up in September, the question is going to be, did you put in the work? Right? And you definitely want that answer to be yes, so they can help you go to the next place. Because if not, what I find a lot of times with clients that I'm working with is if you have not put in the work when they are taking a nap, when they wake up, instead of the universe gradually, you know, walking with you, you start to feel like you're being dragged. So let's make sure whatever it's presenting to you and has shown you over this last handful of months that needs change, that needs to be addressed, that you are putting the work in to get those done. Okay. Now, as we continue on, one of the other things that I keep thinking too with this Pluto energy before I move on is that Pluto is really good for helping you let go of old hurts. Old hurts, old hangups, old beliefs, things like that. So this will be a wonderful time to filter those things out as well. Now, during the middle of the week, I kind of hopped over this, but we have the Sun and Uranus in a conjunction, and this is happening on Wednesday the 18th. This is great because where this energy, this is your vitality meets innovation, meets intuition, meets freedom. You're wanting to get out, you're wanting to make some kind of change. Now, what this can do, just depending on the type of sign that you are, the type of energies you're working with, this can make you very nervous or very anxious energy as well. So if that's happening, it's not gonna last forever. So, you know, don't worry about that too much. Now, this is actually the last Sun Uranus conjunction that we're going to see for a very long time. So this conjunction also makes things pretty unpredictable because Uranus is involved. So we can expect the unexpected with this energy, okay? Now, on the 19th, just the very next day, the Sun is going to move into Taurus. We've got all of this moving and whistling about and unexpected and don't invest and all of this stuff going on. And then the Sun moves into Taurus and we get some stability. This will help also level out your blood sugar, level out your thinking, and this will help you take some sane, sound, maybe a little bit more cautious action as well. But ultimately, what it's going to do is make you want to beautify as well in some way, shape, or form. That's what Taurus is about. Take advantage of that energy. Take advantage of maybe you want to try a new hairstyle. You want to spruce up your home in some way that's very aesthetically pleasing. Maybe you are tuning into the sensuality of your own body. Your budget, any of these things that have value, that bring the value up, that exude some sort of beauty or sensuality, it's all Taurus territory. Now, I will tell you, with the Sun in Taurus as well, you want to be mindful of your body parts, right? You want to be mindful of the throat here. And for me as a Taurus, the other thing I'm always aware of when the Sun comes into Taurus, usually because it's springtime, is how itchy my nose gets because we've got all this pollen and all this other stuff going on. But whatever is happening in your seasonal climate, make sure you're taking care of your body. Watch that throat, watch that voice, okay? All right, guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I look forward to seeing you next week in our weekly video.